today we will start the discussion of animal kingdom. Okay, so here we have completed plant kingdom, so it is totally different from this plant kingdom. This is animal kingdom, and there are certain criteria that we have to discuss first. So first we have to study the features and basis of classification. Features and basis of classification that we will read. In the features, we will read first what are the level of organization. Now you know that classification helps in easy identification and also in assigning a systematic position to newly described species. Now here, Animalia kingdom, normally they are multicellular heterotrophic eukaryotes. So in one place is what is the criteria? These are multicellular and heterotrophic, and these are eukaryotes. So these are the first basic that what is the characteristics of this animal kingdom. Next, if you see now, what is the first criteria that makes something animal? That is the first point is its cellular level. In this level, the body shows some division of labor among cells. So cellular division is there, but gradually from this cellular level, you will get tissue level, because many cells form the tissues, and then many tissues they form organ, and then organ system they will develop, which comprises of some organs, and then they perform the particular function. So this is the basis that you see in animal kingdom. Next one, you will see symmetry. Second point is symmetry. Now what you will see in this symmetry? This can be your bilateral symmetry and then radial symmetry, or actually no symmetry at all. So no symmetry. So there are certain organisms who bear bilateral symmetry, and bilateral symmetry means in some animals, the body can be divided into identical left and right halves in only one plane. Like we will discuss Annelida and Arthropoda, they have. Radial symmetry is that when any plane passing through the central axis of the body divides the organism into two identical halves. So that is radial symmetry. And no symmetry means absolutely no symmetry is present. The next is, this is the criteria, that is symmetry. Third point is whether a body is diploblastic or it is a triploblastic. Diploblastic or triploblastic. Now diploblastic is what? Animals in which the cells are arranged in two embryonic layers, an external ectoderm and internal endoderm. That is diploblastic. But when there is triploblastic, means ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm, all these three are present, then it is called triploblastic animal. These endoderms, ectoderm and mesoderms, these three layers are the germ layers, and that we see in the blastula, that is a gastrular layer that we will discuss in our online class, what are those things. And the next criteria is your coelom, present of coelom. Now what is coelom? If this is a coelomate species, that is without coelom, then if it is coelomate, then it may be the pseudo coelomate species is also there. And if it is coelom is there, then we say it is coelomate. Coelomate, a coelomate, and pseudo coelomate species are there. Now, what is this coelom? The body cavity between the body wall and gut wall, which is lined by mesoderm, is called coelom. A coelomate, that means without coelom, pseudo coelomate, that means false coelom is present, and coelomate means those who are having coelom. that is body cavity between the body wall and the gut wall. Now next one is segmentation. So what kind of segmentation they have? Like you have already studied in earthworm somewhere, it is metameric segmentation. Now annelida, that is earthworm, is having metameric segmentation where the body is divided into many chamber, that is compartments, that is metamere each one. And now the body is again division is there, the body is division, body division is there, means like we have one egg axis and then we have appendages, isn't it? So like this also there is division is there, so axial and appendages are there. So this is the way how segmentation or body is divided into certain segments. And like in cockroach also you can see the abdomen part is segmented, then there is another part thorax, then there is head. And the next one that we discuss is notochord. This is a very important one. By on the basis it is divided like your chordata, that means chordates and non-chordates, that means this backbone is present or backbone is not present. So what is notochord? This is a rod like structure formed on the dorsal side during embryonic development in some animals. So those who have this notochord, they are called chordates, and those who don't have, that is called non-chordates, or we say invertebrates. Okay, now there are various organ systems are present. Organ systems like what are the other important features that here variety of organ systems are there, and that organ systems are respiratory, excretory, digestive, circulatory system, endocrine system, sensory system, skeletal system, all these are organ systems. Now if you say skeletal system, then there is the presence of exoskeleton and endoskeleton. So what are these exos and endos? When the skeletal system present outside the body, that is exo, and endo is inside the body, that is having cartilage and bone, is normally endoskeleton. Now the regarding this the animal can be again hermaphrodite, animal can be bisexual or monoecious, that is unisexual. Then asexual reproduction, sexual reproduction can be seen, external fertilization, internal fertilizations can be seen. So this is the basis of certain criteria on which animal kingdom is divided into many phylums and classes that we'll discuss in our next class. So next class we will discuss invertebrates after this. So please read and ask me your doubts based on this on the online class. Thank you.